son of a bitch.
You need me to throw it and not fall all over myself? I'm so confused. He's very, very bad at walking. Hi, I'm Silvia Saige. Welcome back to another antidote of sexy, funny, raw, where today I'm going to be giving you my opinions on what the internet has called some of the cringeworthiest moments from 90 Day Fiance. Now, this is a show I have watched before, so I know a little bit about the characters that we're about to be seeing, but I don't really know exactly what clips are about to play here. So, here we go.
I'm Ed. I'm 54 years old. People know me as Big Ed. I'm from San Diego, California, and I am a professional photographer.
Who knew there was a professional photographer so close? San Diego is only a few hours. I bet I could get him. Amazing kimono. Should he be wearing them? Kimono! Did he just put mayonnaise on his hair? How have I not seen this episode? First off, this must be like a beginning episode I totally missed because I've only saw them when they were together. He's putting straight up mayonnaise. He took it out of the fridge to put in his hair and he's put gloves on. He's so disgusted by himself he's putting gloves on, but he's still putting mayonnaise in his hair.
Since I met Rose, I want to look young for her.
Aw, he's trying to be young. It's not going to work, but he's trying.
Because Rose is 31 years younger than me.
What? Also new news to me. I didn't realize Rose was 31 years younger than him.
You're so beautiful.
Oh my God.
It's
that first moment they meet and he's like, yes. And she's like, no.
I'm beyond elated.
Somebody tell him to stop doing this movement. This is not your move. This is not good for you. Maybe try this or this, because any elongation you can do of the neck, I'm sure would be appreciated, because this is not your look.
That's you.
You can't find anything nice to say, say nothing at all. That would be me. She's like, you are, let me look at ya. You.
Am I what you expected? Do you like?
I expected you are told to me.
She's handling this real well. He's like, am I everything you expected? She's like, I thought you'd be, you know, taller.
Do you find me attractive?
Attractive always you.
Ooh, why does he keep asking these questions? Like, the answer isn't gonna be good. She's like saying everything possible she can to not say yes. She's the most creative little liar I have ever met, and that's what I really like about her.
Always?
Yeah. Okay.
That look, the look she just gave, this one, that's the truth. That's the truth in her eyes right there. Like, what the fuck have I just flown across the world for? That's a long flight to be highly disappointed upon arrival.
Surprise!
Oh, they made a beautiful setup for him. That's so nice.
It's normal to my family to take a wash together.
Okay, wait. I don't even think I saw this portion of this episode. Now, I do know this couple, but she just said it's normal for her family to wash together. Now, I will say, I always thought he was the one in the relationship that we should be worried about. But I'm very concerned with adult family members still showering together, not in a porn scene.
Oh my God, whoa.
Is he allergic to water? Why is he sneezing? He acts like this is, it's a thing of water on my head.
Nice. This has to be the weirdest experience.
I'm not gonna say that it's not a weird situation, but he's making it weirder than it needs to be. Why is he so afraid of water?
Rose.
Yes, I'm here.
Oh, I dropped the soap.
Drop the soap. You know what that means. Big Daddy's coming in. At least that's what it means in my movies and in prison, I think.
I'm done.
I don't think you're done. You didn't wash any of the important parts. He just got like wet skin at this point. I didn't see soap go anywhere. And with that big boy, I'm gonna need soap to go a lot of places.
Rose, what is that?
I think mouse.
No one knows, a mouse or a rat. It's big. I think just the difference between mice and rats is that they're mice are small and rats are big, right? I mean, that's all I know.
Leg hair, it just seems kind of less feminine for a woman.
You're worried about her leg hair being less feminine. I don't think you have a whole lot of room to be like judging and picking people apart, buddy.
Come on. Either that or you kiss me.
No, okay.
I love this part. This is why I started watching this show, is because of this exact scene when he's like, well, it's either that or you kiss me. And she's like, no. I'll do anything other than kiss you. Shave my legs, shave my head. I'm out. She's like, I can't. Not your face.
Kaya lang parang di siya handa. Baka siya nakasapatos pa siya.
Did he really just put plastic bags around his feet because it's muddy? He's wearing tennis shoes. Bro, get your tennis shoes muddy. You'll be okay.
Right there, okay. Oh God, okay.
He's like a bad infomercial. Do you have a hard time when it's muddy out and you can't feed your animals and you're dropping water all around? I feel like there's gonna be some like salesman coming and like gonna pitch me just being a better man.
Hi, do you speak English? Does anybody speak English?
Why is that the first question you ask? You're not in fucking America, or you're not even in an English-speaking country. Why don't you try to learn their language when you go to their country, jackass? Or why don't you ask your fiance who speaks that language because you're in her country?
The fact that Rose doesn't even have pajamas made me feel really sad.
Who says that? You're upset she doesn't have pajamas? Pajamas are not like a thing that like people like desire. It's not like, oh, I have pajamas, now I have status. Fuck, sleep naked. Who doesn't sleep naked? Let's be honest. I mean, you should be sleeping naked. It's hot in those blankets. But pajamas, what is she, two? She doesn't need pajamas.
Oh yeah, now you have pink.
Princess outfit, that's not pajamas.
You can't just grab from my wallet. Okay, I want to see how much this is. I don't even know how much this is.
Well, she does, so why don't you just let her grab from your wallet?
180?
Awesome.
Keep the change.
Yeah, girlfriend. Keep his change. He doesn't need it.
I don't know if you understand it. It's STD, which is, I think it's a blood test.
Does he know what it is? He's like, I think it's a blood test. It's called a sexually transmitted disease. That's what STD stands for. This guy's a fucking moron. And he's like, I think it's a blood test.
So I was asking if you're willing to take that test, I'll never ask you another question about your past.
I mean, that's a fair deal. We've taken STD tests, I'll never ask you another question about your past. I'd be like, sign me up. I know I can pass that. I can pass an STD test. What I don't know that I can pass is you knowing about my life.
I'm disappointed.
All that traumatic buildup for I'm disappointed. She thinks that he doesn't trust her. That's what it is. I get it.
Book your new hotel and okay. I want to go to sleep and go to home and work.
Okay. Do not believe in love.
Oh, that one's gone viral too. I've seen that one a few times. I do not believe in love. And can I just say, I relate to that statement. What is love anyway, you know? You should just be banging people, it feels a lot better.
What is love? Baby, don't hurt me. Don't hurt me no more.
All right, well, I guess that does it for today, you guys. I hope you enjoyed what you saw. If you did, click like, subscribe, and until next time. Bye, guys.